March 7th, 2020 was the last silent movie night, a week before we closed down because of the, you know, 2 weeks to flatten the curve. So here we are, 18 months later. We get to do 2021 movies today. When I was doing research, I found this piece. UB Blake was from Baltimore. It was called The Baltimore Buzz. I thought, well, even if it's a dumb piece of music, I'm going to have to play it. But it was kind of a fun little, piece of music. I'd never heard it before. I don't know. You can go on and find bands from 1920 playing it. The cartoon coming up, again, 1921, Winsor McCay. He preceded Walt Disney and did a lot of the groundbreaking work for pictures that moved. So how many of you saw the movie Up with Ed Asner? This is kind of what that movie was sort of based on in a way, except the house takes off and flies rather than floats with balloons. So it's not quite as scientifically accurate as Up was. So, this was a whole series of films. Most of them have been lost, called Visions of a Rare Bit Fiend, where the guy eats something before he goes to bed and has nightmares. This is one of the few that survived the flying house, 1921, Winsor McCay.
Thank you.
Back in 1921, everybody pretty much did their own stunts. And this is kind of two movies stitched together. There's the first half of the movie, which doesn't seem to have a whole lot to do with the second half of the movie, but just roll with it. It's the 1921, it's fine. This is one of those cases where you wonder what Harold Lloyd was thinking doing some of these stunts up here in the air like this. It takes place in the city. It's a love story. It's a story of heartbreak. It's a story of being up in a skyscraper somehow when you're not supposed to be up in the air. I don't know. But it is entertaining. Harold Lloyd, 1921. And when I chose the 10 from the 20s, I didn't hear a whole lot of people hollering out names out here like I usually do. You're supposed to be hollering out the names as you come along, if you recognize them, if you don't. The original plan was I was going to put down, like Chuck Connors came up. He spent 4 years in the Army teaching people to drive tanks. He never went overseas. He stayed here the whole time, won some medals. I started listing the medals. Then it came to John Glenn, and the man won like 90 medals or something. I thought, well, I can't list all these, but you notice what all those guys had in common being built in 1911 is they all served during World War II. Chuck Connors, his dream was to play for the Brooklyn Dodgers. And he spent 3 years in minor league ball, got called up and got to play one game in the major leagues with the Brooklyn Dodgers. And then he went on to acting. So here we go. This is Never Weaken. Another thing, I have no idea what the title has to do with the movie at all. If you guys can figure it out, tell me afterwards.